Christmas.
We are so excited to be joining you once again for Christmas at home. And we're here at Shepherd's Corner in beautiful, sunny Woodville. It is absolutely beautiful here. And it's such a joy to be sharing Christmas once again with your families.
Absolutely. We so hope that you are having a fantastic Christmas weekend, full of peace and joy and celebration. And wherever you're watching this, why don't you sing along and enjoy our Christmas carols?
Sweet head, the stars in Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Worthy is your name, Jesus. You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name. Your name.
This time of year, there is a sound in the air, a sound at the table. This time of year, when truth is revealed, a baby was born in a manger. This time of year, gather round everyone, come round the table. For he is alive. Tell everyone, gather your children, worship the sun. And now this Christmas, do not forget to ever sing holy.
Holy night.
angels cried, holy, holy, oh holy night, oh holy night, oh holy night. The angels cried, holy, holy, oh holy night.
Do you have like an ideal image of Christmas in your mind? Is it the Christmas tree with all the lights and all the presents around the base? Or maybe it's like the table that you've just seen where it's like all long and seats and big family is all around it and it's the garland and the candles. Or maybe you're dreaming of a white Christmas. I don't know, we don't get many of them in Australia. We don't get much snow in December, that's for sure. I don't know about you, but I know for me, one of the ideal images in my mind is that image of the table, that long table with food all over it and the crackers and the candles and everyone's wearing those silly hats that we get out of the crackers. But let's be honest, that's not really reality often. Often the reality of our Christmas table looks quite different. Maybe family members can't come this year, or maybe some people aren't welcome around your Christmas table, or maybe some people are just traveling or on the other side of the world, or maybe you're a family that has experienced the pain of loss and so there's an empty seat at your Christmas table this year. I'm not sure, but what I know is that the images that we have in our minds of this ideal Christmas table is often very different to reality. And often we're kind of sold maybe a little bit of a lie with marketing and media and those sorts of things that paint for us this picture of the ideal Christmas, the white Christmas with the snow and the carolers walking the streets and the big long table with the food and the turkey. And I mean, most of us in Australia, we're looking at prawns and mangoes. We don't even want the big hot Christmas lunch if it's 30 degrees outside, right? But here's the thing. Even the original Christmas story that we read in the Bible of Mary and Joseph and the donkey, I mean, that paints for us the reality that the Christmas is far from ideal. It's far from the picture perfect image that sometimes we're sold by media or those sorts of things. In fact, that Christmas story tells us that the reality of Christmas is sometimes full of a whole lot more dysfunction than maybe we would like to admit. I mean, they rock up and there's not even any room for them at the inn. I don't know if you've been one of those families that's hosted family Christmas and you're like, where are we going to put everybody? We're moving beds upstairs, downstairs. We're getting camping mattresses out. I mean, this year we're even looking at putting a tent up in the backyard, right? Kids can stay outside. I don't know if that's your experience. I know it's ours and it feels like there's no room at our inn either. But even if we talk about the Christmas table, I mean, Mary and Joseph, they're in a stable. And if we're honest, the first Christmas table Jesus experiences is the animal's Christmas table. I mean, he's laid in the manger, he's laid in the feeding trough, he's laid in the animal's Christmas table, if I can, you know, stretch the analogy that far. We got cows and sheep looking at him going, who's this lying all over our Christmas table? I want my Christmas hay, I don't want a baby in the way. Right? I love that about the story of Christmas. I love that the true story of Christmas doesn't try to tell us that life is going to be ideal, but it meets us right in the reality of our lives. And the truth is that from that point on in Jesus's life, he remodels the idea of the table. there is not another point that we see where there is not enough room at the table for someone that Jesus is at. He invites all sorts of people to come and sit at the table with him. Whether it's tax collectors like Zacchaeus, whether it's women who have a somewhat questionable past, or whether it's the religious elite or those who the religious elite would classify as not welcome or sinners, those that should be shunned or separated, and whether it's his disciples or people from his actual family, Jesus spends the rest of his life welcoming people to the table. And he actually tells this story. It's a story of a wedding banquet. And he says that this king is holding this wedding banquet. He sends out all these invitations, and those that he initially invites, well, they're not interested in coming. But this king says, you know what? I want people to be welcome to the table. So go and invite everybody. Go and invite those who are lame. Go and invite those who are blind. Go and invite those who are crippled. Go and invite every single person who is out in the highways or the byways of the cities. Invite them to come in. And it's this story that is an image that Jesus is explaining what it's like to have a life with him. Every single person is welcome and invited to a life with Jesus. You are welcome to the table of life with Christ. And that's a bit of an interesting term, to be welcome to the table of life, but that's the invitation of Jesus. It's actually an invitation into a life where it's as if we are seated at the table with him. What does that mean? Well, when we think about that table that we started with, that Christmas table, we think about the beauty of relationship. We think about connection with others. We think about contentment and satisfaction, food and sharing of gifts. We think about joy and peace and just the beauty of relationship. We think about joy and vibrancy. That table at Christmas is full of life and laughter and enjoyment. And that is a picture of life with Jesus. That's a picture of the table that he invites us into. He welcomes us to do life at the table with him, to enjoy connection with him, conversation with him, relationship with him, peace with him, vibrancy with him. Our life gets to be full of life because of Jesus. And no matter where you are as you watch this today, I want you to remember two things. Number one, I want you to remember that Jesus is with you. Whether you are eating a Christmas meal with your whole family, with lots and lots of people, or maybe you're watching this and you're by yourself this Christmas, you're separated from loved ones this Christmas, you might be feeling isolated, alone, disconnected. I'm telling you right now, Jesus is with you. And number two, I want to tell you that you are invited to the table with him, the table of your life, the table of his life, that place with him where you can find peace and joy, satisfaction, contentment, vibrancy, buoyancy, and peace. But above all, you can find forgiveness and grace. I'm telling you, it is an invitation that is open to every single person. No matter where you are, no matter what you've done, you are invited to the table with Jesus. Merry Christmas. Have a fantastic weekend.
Oh,